Assalamu alaikum, brothers and sisters. I hope you are well. Sri Lanka has taken a significant step towards banning the burqa and other face coverings in public on grounds of national security, Public Security Minister Sarath Weerasekara told the BBC that he had signed a cabinet order which now needs parliamentary approval. Officials say they expect the ban to be implemented very soon. The move comes nearly 2 years after a wave of coordinated attacks on hotels and churches on Easter Sunday. As the authorities tracked down the militants, an emergency short-term ban on face coverings was implemented in the majority Buddhist nation. Now, the government is moving to reintroduce it on a permanent basis. Astaghfirullah. Mr. Weerasekara told reporters that the burqa was a sign of religious extremism that came about recently. He added that it was affecting national security and that a permanent ban was overdue. "So I have signed that and it will be implemented very soon," he said. Mr. Weerasekara also said the government planned to ban more than 1,000 madrasa Islamic schools, which he said were flouting national education policy. "Nobody can open a school and teach whatever you want to the children. It must be as per the government laid down education policy. Most of unregistered schools teach only the Arabic language and the Quran, so that is bad," he said. Astaghfirullah. The government's plan moves follow an order last year making the cremation of COVID-19 victims mandatory, in line with the practice of majority Buddhists, but against the wishes of Muslims and Christians who bury their dead. However, this ban was lifted earlier this year after criticism from the US and international rights groups. Last month, the United National Human Rights Council session considered a new resolution on mounting rights concerns in Sri Lanka, including over the treatment of the Muslims. Brothers and sisters, never until now had a democratically elected government in Asia felt the need to exact a ban on face covers. An exception to this is China, where face veils are indeed banned. There, however, government repression of Uyghur Muslims is systematic and operates on a universal consensus that is cruel. To harness the future of a nation's safety to a measure that affects the personal freedom of women is certainly a novelty in Asia, which brings us to the question if such a move exists to normalize the rhetoric of the European far right. Brothers and sisters, Wheeling is the mascot of the most enlightened Muslim girls who are pursuing prestigious courses in top-class universities. Attempts to force Muslim women to stop wearing the veil might, therefore, be counterproductive by depriving them of the choice and opportunity to integrate. If women cannot signal their piety through wearing a veil, they might choose or be forced to stay at home. Prophet Muhammad ﷺ said, "Every religion has a chief characteristic, and the chief characteristic of Islam is modesty." So brothers and sisters, to cut this short, no country ever needs a burqa ban in the name of a national security. A woman wears a hijab or a niqab for her protection, for her modesty from others and because it's her choice, not because of she's been oppressed and forced by others to do so. MashaAllah. If you're a sister doing the hijab or the niqab, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep you strong in continuing so. Ameen. So that's it for today, guys. Let us know what you think about the Sri Lankan burqa ban by commenting down below. Also, like, share and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. Until next time, Assalamu alaikum.